that got people's attention. Many noticed the newspaper ads for Clinton with the Alpha Phi Omega fraternity welcoming their broad to Manila. The timing of the ads led professional heckler Loy Landicho to joke that Apple members had so much fun with their broad, it was a blast. Apple member Vice President Jejomar Binay confirmed that Clinton is a frat member.
Oo, kaya nga mga lumalabas na suspect-suspect ka nga po, masususpect pa si Bill Clinton.
So where was the frat party? So where was the frat party?
No, you know, I have to say that Apple, I think, has a legitimate beef when it points out that the DOJ should not demand that they surrender these people based solely on innuendo. I think it's right for Apple to demand that, where are the charges? You know, identify these people before you expect us to turn them over. But then when they like extend their argument to this tenuous relationship with Bill Clinton, it kind of undermines
it. It was clearly a PR stunt for people to.
But it's really Apple, right? I mean,
it's some sort of affiliation.
Honorary in Georgetown in the batch of 66.
How flimsy pala the connection. But they maximized it.
But apparently, it was a publicity stunt for people to associate them with Bill Clinton rather than that the unfortunate incident.
But that's it. I think it makes it undermines sana what I thought were very useful arguments they had going naman in there.
So you think
I just had a vision of
Bill Clinton.
No, Jojo Binay doing the oblation run. Oh my goodness.
Oh dear God.
All right, for people who don't know, Alpha Phi Omega is actually the frat that does the oblation run where students, neophytes run naked. I wonder if Vice President Binay actually did that.
I'm sure he did. They all did.
That's funny. Anyway, this is a funny episode. He's not a comedian, but Manny Pacquiao sure is funny. What's not funny is how he and at least 15 other Congress representatives will skip session for his match with Antonio Margarito this Saturday. Initial reports even said 50 lawmakers will watch it live. The House clarifies the congressmen will use their own money for the Texas trip, and they will be marked absent. But is it time to ban them from leaving Batasan for Pac-Man's fight? I suppose it's their right to watch a boxing match. I just think it's, I don't know, the mass movement is just, it almost looks comical, but it is a comedy episode.
Well, they're supposedly adults and honorable people, and imposing these rules like they're school children would not be appropriate. But I think what we should do is report on who is not doing his job and instead just having a grand time in Texas. And their constituents can decide whether to elect them again. That is, if their constituents are mature enough to do so too.
Mm-hmm. But we have to point out that they've done this every time Pacquiao has had a fight. And that for people to consider a ban now, when this is probably Pacquiao's last fight, if not the second to the last fight, then that's some sort of a futility.
How do we determine if there was something really pressing and that there was something dropped or not handled or pushed because they were in the fight? No, but is there something like that, something empirical like that? Parang, we can fault someone to want to skip work and watch a boxing match, I suppose. But of course, the more sterling ones will not.
But, you know, as a result, I think, of the scrutiny that they've gotten, they're now justifying everything. Mm-hmm. Someone is saying that, I'm going, but then I don't have any scheduled hearings naman on that day.
And this is my own money.
Mm-hmm. And then they're also pointing out that the day after, rather Tuesday, because the match is Sunday, right? Yeah. And then Tuesday is a holiday, so naka-sandwich rin lang naman. It becomes all that more convenient.
Well, I love how we set such sterling examples for our children. I love it.
All right, from the boxing champ, let's move on to the comedy king. Dolphy brought laughter to Malacañang as he received the grand collar of the Order of the Golden Heart, the highest award given to a private citizen. President Aquino recognized Dolphy's achievements in showbiz and philanthropy. Dolphy says he's happy with the award, but his fans renewed calls for him to be named national artist.
Well, hindi ko na iniintindi national artist. Okay na lang sa akin to. Camera po.
Kaya bigyan ako nung hindi, okay na siya. Marami yata kumukontre. Pwede na sa akin ang fan. National arthritis.
I love him.
He's
a
classic.
I really want to interview him. Mm-hmm. He's so fun and his timing.
And I think
amazing.
He deserves to be national artist. I mean, if someone like Arno Caparas can be a national artist, why can't an icon like Toby?
Well, I'm glad that he said that he doesn't want it. It's not important to him, because I do think that for the longest time, the National Artist Award has had nothing to do with artistry, you know, or art. And it's not just Carlo Caparas. I mean, matagal na, I think, even with their having given it to FPJ.
Is it because of the process or the screening? Or I thought it was
it's political. But it started out that way, and then suddenly you other things get mixed up in it, like a sentiment. Which is what I think happened in the case of FPJ. It was a posthumous award, and somehow people wanted to reward him for having been cheated out of the election, diba? And there was no consideration for his body of work, whether his work was art, in fact, but you know.
Well, whatever it is, I think that's one good move of this administration. Honor Dolphy, certainly deserved. Certainly deserved.
Okay, with that color award and not necessarily the National Artist Award.
Okay. Comedian Conan O'Brien is crowned the king of late night in Hollywood with his successful comeback. Conan left TV in January after NBC decided to downgrade him to an early morning time slot to allow Jay Leno to return to The Tonight Show. But revenge is sweet for Coco. With his new show on cable channel TBS beating Leno, David Letterman, and The Daily Show with Jon Stewart in the ratings game.
People ask me why I named the show Conan. I did it so I'd be harder to replace. He's out. Get another Conan. I'm going to be honest, though. It's not easy doing a late night show on a channel without a lot of money that viewers have trouble finding. So that's why I left NBC.
The day after his debut, he actually posted a message on Twitter thanking 4 million people who watched his show and the other 5 million who tried looking for TBS. But some people say he should lose the NBC jokes. It's getting old. Yeah. He should start, you know, giving... Well,
what are you talking about? This was his first episode,
right? No, he has always joked happened to him on NBC.
I think he's entitled to it, though. But you're right. Perhaps it's time for new material. But it's just so fun. It's just so fun to pick on someone who picked on you. So
yes, and
I'll give him that.
I think he will do it once and not in subsequent episodes.
Like, I throughout this episode, I'm always going to pick on me being... declared as asking stupid questions. I mean, I think it's great. I get the whole 35 minutes.
I see how hate mail can affect you. No,
I was just shocked. I'm not used to it. I think I'm so new. Obviously, I'm green. But anyway, it's not all laughter in media. Wow, this is really close to my heart. Our radio show got sacked. After 23 years, NU107, the home of new rock, signs off, giving way to new investors and new programming. Rock jocks and supporters gathered in the station Sunday to listen to NU's Huling El Bimbo. NU supporters believe it's the end of an era, but not the end of Pinoy rock. That's my footage. I took that.